We selected the Arion Lightning XS as the test flight unit for our engine because originally the aircraft was designed around a 120 horsepower engine, and ultimately it has progressed up to a 200 horsepower engine as well too. Given that we're planning to develop a 120 horsepower engine as well, we figured that the Lightning could be a test bed for both our 200 horsepower launch engine and also our 120 horsepower engine when we got to that program. It was a combination of not only performance, ability to accept both engines, but also its good looks as well too, because after we use it as a test bed, we'd like to use it as a demonstrator for our engine. And we selected a two-seater because that way we could take people along to demonstrate the smoothness and power of the turbine as well too. For this particular aircraft, we purchased it along with some support from the Sir Ross and Keith Smith Fund here in South Australia, and myself and a university student from the University of Adelaide went across and participated in the Builder Assist program to actually build the aircraft. So I can proudly say that part of this is my work. We then had it shipped to our facility here in Adelaide, where we intend to install the engine in it once we've completed the development program for the engine. The Lightning XS has recently been fitted with 200 horsepower piston engines. Of course, we're intending to install our 200 horsepower Talon turboprop engine into it, and we expect improved performance over the piston engine power plant because of our ability to be able to streamline the cowling better and also with the lighter weight of our engine. We're expecting exceptional performance from this Lightning XS. Generally, they cruise at about 160 knots. We're going to be able to cruise at 180 knots, which is about as good as you're going to get from a Lightning. We're fortunate with our program to have a number of test pilots involved with our program at the moment, both from the perspective of investors and also customers as well too. One of our test pilots is a former British Aerospace test pilot, senior test pilot, who has volunteered to undertake our flight test program for us. We expect that he's going to bring some instrumentation from his flight test business that he operates to allow us to fully document the flight test program. We'll be releasing more information in the future about our flight test program, and we'll certainly introduce our test pilot along the way. He is one that is recognised worldwide. You're going to find his background itself very interesting. So the aircraft's arrived in our workshop now, as you can see here. We're looking forward to getting the engine installed on it around about the middle of next year and getting into the flight test program. So here is the engine mount that's typically used on the Arion XS. This specific one was established for the Jabiru. Of course, our turbine is going to be on here to replace it. This is the new lower cowling for the engine. You'll note that there are no air intakes here for the cylinders. It's very smooth from where the spinner is going to be all the way through to the fuselage sides. What that means to us and what that means to the performance of the Arion is that it's going to be aerodynamically cleaner, and for the same power, we're going to get better performance as a result of the aerodynamic improvements. Of course, we're developing the firewall forward installation for our specific aircraft, the Arion. However, we're working with a number of companies who are also going to be developing firewall forward packages for a lot of the other popular aircraft, such as the RVs, Lanciers, Glaciers as well too. So that'll make the installation a lot easier for our community. So thanks for watching our video today about our Arion aircraft. To ensure you don't miss out on any updates in the future about our engine or our aircraft, please subscribe to us on YouTube, hit the bell notification, also follow us on Facebook, and as always, safe flying.